At this point, we've already seen the most basic data structure for modeling uncertainty in this course, which is what's called a probability space, which we'll also sometimes call a probability model. Okay, and this is the thing that consists of two ingredients, the sample space, omega, and an assignment of probabilities, p. Okay, and we'll write a probability space as a pair, so in parentheses, of these two items. Okay, so it looks like, for example, a tuple in Python. All right, and as we saw, you might be wondering, why are there two ingredients when I can write this as a single Python dictionary? And so the important thing to note is that to understand the mathematics of what's going on, it's actually good to be able to keep track of what these two things are, which is why we give them two different names. All right. And in this video, we'll start to see some of how the mathematical notation looks like. All right. And so often when we talk about probability spaces, we'll draw out a picture, like, for example, a box that represents the sample space. And we'll have, for example, points to say the points are the outcomes in the sample space. And we'll often refer to a specific outcome with the variable little omega. Okay, as a reminder, the two requirements we have are that for each of the outcomes, little omega, in the sample space, big omega, we ask that the probability, okay, of the outcome little omega is at least 0 and at most 1. Okay, and the other requirement, that the probabilities of all the outcomes sum to 1, we would write that by saying the, so this is thing number one. The other thing is we want the sum of, so sum over all the little omega, the outcomes that are in the sample space, okay, of probability of omega, this thing needs to equal 1. Okay, recall from our coin flipping example, we had the sample space equals, now I'll abbreviate heads with just H and tails with T, okay? And so, of course, we had probability of heads equals probability of tails equals 1/2 when the coin is fair. And something to note is that for a probability space, we can always represent it as a table, okay? So given one of these omega P pairs, which is a probability space, we can write it out as the table as follows. So for the fair coin flip, we have heads, tails. Okay, so these are the outcomes. And we have the probability of these outcomes, which is 1/2, 1/2. Okay? And note that this table representation, okay, so sometimes we'll call this a table representation. This table representation fully encodes everything there is to know about the probability space. So to give another example, if I told you, if I gave you the following table, okay, I said outcome, I have sunny, rainy, and snowy, and I told you, okay, the probability of these are 1/2, 1/6, and 1/3. Immediately, just by looking at this table, you can tell me, okay, these three items, that's the sample space omega, and the assignment of probabilities is exactly given by, well, probability of sunny is 1/2, probability of rainy is 1/6, probability of snowy is 1/3. Okay, and you can check that these actually do add up to 1. Okay, so in this sense, a probability space, okay, a probability space can always be represented by one of these tables of non-negative entries that add to 1. In that sense, you can think of this as a data structure. And in Python, so we saw the dictionary way of representing this. So we would write something like, so now in self-calling model, we call it probability space, okay, equals sunny 1/2, rainy 1/6, snowy 1/3. So we can represent it as a dictionary like so. A different way that we can represent this, which we'll sometimes use, is to actually write out the outcomes and the probabilities as two separate lists, okay? So for example, we might say outcomes equals sunny, sunny, rainy, snowy, and then the probabilities. So the usually when we list out the probabilities, so we have 1/2, 1/6, 1/3. Usually we'll actually write out a vector of numbers as a numpy array. Okay, so we'll have mp for numpy dot array. Okay, and basically using numpy to store arrays and deal with arrays will make certain operations faster. But basic idea is that this here is a different way to also encode the probability space, where the zeroth entry corresponds to the zeroth entry here, so probability of sunny is 1/2, and so forth, okay? Finally, a quick remark is that the probability spaces we'll be dealing with in this class are actually what we call finite probability spaces or finite probability models. Okay, but we'll often just not write this finite thing to keep things nice and short. And by that, we just mean that the sample space omega has only a finite number of outcomes in it, which means that there isn't an infinite number of outcomes. And so this is a fairly natural constraint in that, for example, in how we write out the dictionary representation in Python, we can't just specify an infinite number of keys, okay? So similarly, for a finite probability space, there's only a finite number of outcomes in the sample space omega. At the end of the first section of the course, we'll see some examples of where we have an infinite number of outcomes in the sample space. In the next video, Lizong Zhang, one of the other instructors, will continue talking about probability spaces and get into what are called events. And he'll be sticking to calling probability spaces probability models.